What's going on, y'all? It's the Caveman back at it again with another video. And coming another video comes another week of Bills football. And the Bills came out with another W. And what else can we say? We went in, we beat a team that we should have beaten, a team that really has been struggling this year in the LA Chargers. They really have had no luck whatsoever, but they also have screwed themselves over with time management issues, coaching issues. But they definitely have the talent. They're definitely a team on paper that we could have troubling time beating, but we did take them down. We had a decent lead, and once again we pulled the Buffalo Bills and we let them come back in the game. But we took care of business in the end, as we do per usual. But instead of just focusing on the game as a whole, I thought the game was pretty good. There were a couple of things that I do want to touch on real quick, but the main focus on this video is what happened at the end of the game. Now, some people might not think this is a big deal, but to me, this is a bit concerning. Now, the second week in a row now, or the second game in a row, because we didn't play last week, the Bills gave up a Hail Mary play. It was like fourth in fucking country miles, fourth in Asia, fourth and 30 or whatever Justin Herbert had at the end of the game, and he chucks up a Hail Mary. There were about two Chargers wide receivers there, and there was about four or five Bills defensive backs. He chucks up a Hail Mary, and it gets caught again. We are going through this deja vu all over again. What just happened to us? DeAndre Hopkins caught a game-winning Hail Mary to win the game. It's like, why is this happening again? This doesn't really make any sense. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. You know, it's that kind of mantra that I keep thinking of when I think of this scenario. Like, the first time I was pissed, like when I mentioned it the last time I talked about it in my video, I was pissed about that Hail Mary at first with DeAndre Hopkins and the Cardinals. I was mad. I really was. And then I sat back. I'm like, you know, sometimes miracles happen and sometimes you're not always on the right end of it. And that's just how it is. DeAndre Hopkins is one of the best receivers, if not the best receiver in the league. And he's miraculous. He's spectacular. It was just one of those things where it's a miracle. Miracles happen and we just weren't on the right end of it. It was just kind of preaching right after. It's like, you could tell that the Bills defenders, they were going for the ball or they were going for the pick, instead of jumping up to impede DeAndre Hopkins from catching the ball or impede the ball from getting to DeAndre Hopkins. They were going for the pick. Now, you could say going for the pick is trying to stop DeAndre Hopkins from getting the ball. And yes, it is. But you're the defender. You're not supposed to be going for the ball. You're supposed to be stopping the offensive player from getting the ball. No, I sat back and I said, I'm not going to be that guy. I'm not going to be upset about it. I'm just going to accept what happened. We're on the wrong side of it. And that's that. Rachel Bush, who is the wife or girlfriend or whatever, the significant other of Jordan Poyer, actually did tweet out after the game her opinion on it. And if I can find it, I'll throw it up on the screen. But pretty much she was saying, like, if you look at it from a player's perspective, they have incentives as far as stats. And that's why they go for the ball. And that's why you need to understand that. But that doesn't matter to me. Like, I'm sorry, but you're making a lot of money. That extra $1 or $2 million for maybe having a threshold of 6 picks, that's, in my opinion, unacceptable. If that's what you're going for as an individual on a team, you're going for your extra incentives when you're trying to win a Super Bowl, then you are playing on that team for the wrong reason. I understand if you're on the fucking New York Jets, or if you're on another shit-ass team, the New York Giants, and you're going for interceptions at the end of the game to help your personal being, and yeah, fine. But you're on the Bills, we're going for a Super Bowl, we're trying to win games. You're not going for that extra $1 or $2 million. You're going for the win. And us going for the interception on that play, on a play like that, is not going for the win. It's going to help yourself, is pretty much the way I think about it. And Rachel Bush's tweet kind of only further proves that point for me. So I do think the Bills actually have a Hail Mary problem. And it's really fucking concerning, because you might as well just run out and throw up a 4 verticals play every fucking time you're on offense and Bills, because it's going to fucking get caught. Like, we're 0-for-2 on them now on the year. That's not good. Like, those are plays that will lose us games. And you know what? It would have taken an extra miracle and a half for the Chargers to win that game. But they got one by catching that ball. It was 4th and 30. They got one from that. It's just, you need to play defense. We're not out there playing fucking jackpot. We're not out in the backyard trying to get jackpot for 2,000 points and like sticky feet. We're not doing that shit. We're out there trying to win a fucking football game, not the extra $1 million you get for having 6 interceptions. It riles me up to think about it, because it's unacceptable. I'm sorry, but it's unacceptable. There's a point where I understand that a win is a win and I should be happy about it. And I am happy. Even though it was an ugly ass win, we won the fucking game. Josh Allen did not look that great. He threw some interceptions that he really shouldn't have. He didn't look that great. The offensive line and pass protection fucking looked horrible. Josh Allen almost got hurt. Like, there were a lot of shit that went wrong in this game. We came out with the win though. And the running game actually didn't look that bad, which was the impressive part. I guess that's the biggest takeaway from this game, is that the running game actually looked pretty good. But that's not what I'm talking about in this video. We have issues that need to be addressed. I'm not gonna go with a win is a win anymore, because if we want to be a better team, a win is not gonna cut it. It comes down to a playoff game, really important game, where we are one and done at the end of the year, and we are fighting for that extra, we're fighting for that extra yard to win the game, or we're fighting for that extra pass deflection, and we have a Hail Mary converted on us, or we have some, I don't know, just some ungodly miracle happen against us where we lose a game. It's gonna be sickening. And I mean, if I even want to stretch the narrative some more, Deshaun Watson getting out of that sack last year, man, that was an unfortunate event. And I'm not saying anybody was trying to boost their incentives or anything, but it's just like, my point is that one extra play, it only takes one play for a game to just not fall in your favor. It only takes one play. And that Deshaun Watson play last year was that one play at the end of the game. We sack in there, we win that game. We do. We stop DeAndre Hopkins from catching the ball, we win that game. It's just that extra play, that one last play, no matter how little a probability there is for the other team to convert whatever they're trying to convert. We need to follow through, and we didn't follow through against DeAndre Hopkins. We didn't follow through at the end of the Chargers game with that extra Hail Mary. We won the game, but a win is a win is not going to cut it for me anymore. What you guys think? Do you think this is a problem for the Bills? Do you think I'm overreacting? Do you think a win is a win is the mantra here? Do you think we should be able to say that and be comfortable as Bills fans and be confident in our team? Let me know what you guys think down below. I think I've made my point clear. We need to figure some shit out, and giving up Hail Marys twice in a row now, that's no coincidence here, guys. Like, subscribe, do all the fun stuff. I'll be back at it again with another video this week, coming tomorrow probably, and I'll see y'all later. Peace.